guys, welcome back to our channel. Today I want to start off with one of the No Zoresis braided lace wigs, and this one is the butterfly lock style. Butterfly lock, that's what it's called. Diva lace butterfly lock, and I have her in the color FS4/27. Now I think I've gotten a butterfly lock already by Zoresis. I think it's like about one or two last week. I don't remember the names, but I know that they were butterfly locks. And I'm actually lying. I think I got one butterfly lock, which was kind of short, and then I got another one, like another regular lock or something like that. Was it? That was short as well. And then I got a braided lace wig that was long. That's what I got, a braided lace wig that was long. So this one is made up just like the long braided lace wig that I reviewed by Zoresis. I think it was last week, if I'm not mistaken. I think it was last week. So pretty much it's made up the same. So first of all, you only get a lace part in the wig. So there's not a 4x4. Normally with the braided lace wigs, sometimes we get like a little 4x4. They haven't made it where we could get like a 13x6 as yet, but we're gonna take what we could get for now, which is a 4x4. But this one doesn't have the 4x4, just a lace part, okay? So it's a right side part, and the parting space is not clear at all. So it's very clustered, like you can see the part is there, but it's very clustered, like you really have to go in there. I think the first thing I did when I put this on was add powder to the parting space, because I thought that that would bring it all together. Meaning like it would give some definition and let me know, okay, what's really going on and how I should, you know, lay the baby hairs and stuff like that. So that's pretty much what happened. So I just added powder to the part, and this is a braided wig, so you can't, when I say braided, it's locks, braid, same thing. So you can't really go in and tweeze the part. So that's the next thing, you can't really do that. So like I said, I went in deep in there and I added the powder to the parting space, and then I went ahead and I cut the baby hairs down and just laid that down. Now, okay, because the hair, like I said, the parting space is so dense, like the hair is just in there, clustered in there. It's the same thing with the hairline. So you don't get much lace at the front. Like, this is a lace front. I did cut the lace off. But when I say that, you don't have, like, extra lace in the front where you have, like, a natural hairline. There's nothing natural about the hairline. The locks actually start right, you could say the locks is on top of the baby hairs pretty much, okay? So you have to go in there. I think the baby hairs actually made it look a little bit better, a little bit more possible, because of how dense the front of it is. I think with a wig like this, I would just get some braiding hair, go in, lock my hair in the front, right, like one or two rows in the front, and then put the wig from the back, because just so it looks a little bit more natural, you know what I mean? But at the same time, I think the wig would look a little bit puffy in the back there if you pull it back. I don't know. But guys, that's what's going on with the whole front, like the whole hairline and stuff like that. Now let's get into the actual style of the wig. First of all, the way the hair is laid on, like the way the locks is laid on the cap, it has like that little stitch, you know, that little thread that you get. I think last week I was trying to like cut the braids apart to let it down. So before I went into all that today, I decided to look at it before I even put the wig on, and I looked at it and I realized, like, right behind here, if you were to, you know what, let me come closer so you guys can see, give you guys a visual of what I'm talking about. Okay, so we're up close and personal now. So if I were to take the stitches out, this is what you're gonna see at the back. So this is a braided cap. The cap is actually braided down. You see this? This is not, like, looking at it from a distance, it don't it look like nothing, it's fine, whatever. But if you look at it up close, you can just see that there's locks along here, and then there's braids all the way here. So it's very spaced out. There's another lock here, like it's very spaced out in between there. So the fact that it's like down, let me show you what it looks like down, by the way. This is what it looks like down. So like I said, you would have to go in and cut the stitch out that's holding everything together. But the reason why I did not do that is because once you take this down, I don't know what's gonna go on. I don't want to see this bare space, you know, right there. I don't want to see that. So I was like, you know what, the best thing for me to do is leave it as is and just take a little bit of hair right here, so it could kind of look as if I'm the one that pulled this back into like a little, you know, not back here. And because I'm so close, let me just go ahead and show you the lock pattern. And again, everything is pretty much the same, just like the Sensational one that I reviewed. They're pretty much the same. Let me show you one at a time so maybe you can see it a little bit better. This is the butterfly lock, okay? And each lock is pretty much the same. So you get like a uniformed lock. That's what you get, all right? So yeah, so that's why I pulled this back. Just give it a little knot back here. That way it looks like I'm the one pulling this back and it's not just like there, like stuck to the back in a sense. You get what I'm saying? So if you want, you could take it out and like put it up in a ponytail, wear like a headband or something on it. I think that would make it look so cute, but I mean, it's really up to you how you want to like go ahead and style this. Let me show you the stock card, by the way. This is what the stock card looks like here. This is a stock card, and the cap itself, you get two combs up front, one at the back, the adjustable straps, and you have a stretchable mesh net cap. It doesn't stretch that much, but it stretches a little bit, so you would have some stretch in there that can definitely fit a larger head size, I would say. But anyway guys, this is pretty much it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, leave it in the comment section down below. Let me know what you think about this here in the comment section down below. Let me know if you have any intentions of purchasing it or not. But like I said, the link would be down there just in case you are interested in purchasing it. And thanks again for watching. Like, subscribe, follow us on all our social media accounts. Everything is at Wig Tyson. I'll see you soon. Bye.